Hello, everyone. Welcome to today's Daily Touchpoint. Our reading for today is in 1 Thessalonians 5. Now, this is the closing chapter of Paul's first letter to the church in Thessalonica. In it, he reminds the church to always be ready and hold fast the blessed hope of our Savior's imminent return for his saints. Along with his encouragements, Paul also gives instructions on how every follower of Jesus should conduct themselves while waiting for this blessed hope. Now, out of this chapter, I want us to check out three essential practices the Apostle Paul laid out for us to live by while waiting for Jesus' return. These practices are short and to the point, yet their significance in the Christian life is so central that he called them God's will for every believer. Let's read them, starting in verse 16. Rejoice in the Lord always. Pray continually. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. So it's always be joyous, pray without ceasing, and give thanks in all circumstances. I don't know about you, but at first glance, these instructions sound impossible, right? I mean, does this actually say that you have to be smiling all the time, to never stop praying, and to thank God even when terrible things happen? Now, if Paul had only said, rejoice a lot, pray often, and try to be thankful, maybe I could say, okay, that's doable. I'll try to do that. But reading the word always here and knowing my capacity for inconsistency makes these commands seem unattainable. So how then should we understand this passage? I believe the key to truly comprehending this passage was also given to us by Paul in saying that these practices are God's will for us in Christ Jesus. In other words, all the commands are to be Christ-focused, viewing them through the lens of who He is, what He's done for us, and what we have in Him. Let's take the first command, to rejoice always, and add Paul's key phrase, in Christ Jesus. So we can read it as, rejoice always in Christ Jesus. Now that actually makes sense that we should always be joyful because in Christ Jesus, we have received a new and wondrous identity. Imagine being elevated into not only a child of the Most High, but also a co-heir with Jesus who rules the heavens and earth. I realize that's hard to fully grasp with our limited mind, but I know it's better than winning the biggest lottery in history because what we have been given is permanent and it will take all of eternity for us to enjoy. Yes, we may not always feel buoyant and cheerful, and there are definitely times of difficult circumstances where we naturally don't feel like rejoicing. But that's when we need to remind ourselves of the amazing news of our salvation in Christ Jesus. And let the joy that comes with knowing we have been chosen to be a recipient of His lavish love and grace sink in. Next, we are to pray always. Now, I believe that prayer is not just in the moving of the lips, but in the elevation of our hearts to God. We are to be conscious of God's presence with us throughout the day, keeping a line of communication open with Him. I've heard someone describe it as having an open telephone line. It doesn't mean you're always talking, but a channel of communication that's always open where you know someone is on the other end listening and ready to respond. The awareness and recognition of His presence in every moment is already a form of prayer. Finally, give thanks in all circumstances. Now, this doesn't mean that we are to blindly delight in whatever difficult circumstance we are faced with, because the key word here is in all, not for all circumstances. Paul never instructed the church to thank God for evil events, but to thank Him that even in hard times and circumstances, our hope is rock solid. His promises remain and God continues to work in our lives. The scriptures are clear. Rejoice with those who rejoice and mourn with those who mourn. There is a time for everything. Our thankfulness should rise above our circumstance, good or bad, because it is directed not at our situation, but in Christ. His finished work at the cross has given us a hope and a future. CA, let me encourage you today to find your joy in the Lord always, knowing that He has lavished you with His extravagant love and guaranteed your future. Set your heart towards Him. Constantly recognize His presence to make your life a prayer. And finally, always give thanks in whatever season you find yourself in, because His love will never fail and our hope is eternally secured. Let's pray. Father, continue to create in us a joyous, worshipful, and grateful heart. We want to do Your will in our lives. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Hope you guys were blessed. We'll see you again next time.